Now, for this section, we're going to look at animations. So it's going to look at getting your presentations to start looking that wee bit better. I have this one on the screen at the minute. It's going to be the main reason you would use animations. If you are speaking about four things like we have here. So people tend to read on ahead when you're speaking. So we might want to talk about the 3.5 kilometers of beach. Whereas people are reading on about restaurants and bars. So it's a good idea if you can keep the things you have on the screen until you're ready to show them. So what we're going to do is we'll do first of all. So we're going to click into where the placeholder is. Again, very important. Always click into where the placeholder is. And we select the first bullet point. And we have the animations tab. I have it open here. So the animations tab, and again, you can see very similar to earlier on, like we have with the transitions and the design themes and so on. So we have these green ones here, and the green are for entrance. Okay, so you can see here we have the entrance ones. So again, there's basic ones, there's subtle, there's moderate, and then they start getting a wee bit mad. Okay, so we're going to use, I'm just going to use this fly-in one. Okay, I'm going to click on it. And it's going to show you what's going to happen. It's after opening up the animations tab on the right hand side, but you can see it happens. Now, there's a quick tip I'm going to give you now. When you select it, we're going to do the second one. I select it, I'm going to go up to the top, I'm going to fly in. It's going to do the animation, and there's going to be a number appearing beside it on the left hand side. So watch it. Okay. So it's showing the order that they're coming in. So don't try to rush on too far ahead before you have that done. So click it, give yourself a couple of seconds. Now it's okay to go and do the next one. Don't do it too quick. Let it do its thing. Let it do its... Okay, so I'm after putting the order in there. If you want, on the right hand side here, you can see you can change the order to come in. You would never want to do that because you want them to come in the order that they do. Okay, I'm going to do this one here as well. So this is just a bit of text. I'm going to select the text. And again, I'm going to use fly in for this. I am a great believer of always having everything the same right the way through it, because if it's not the same, people are waiting to see what's coming next as opposed to listening to you speaking. So I'm going to start my slideshow. Go to slideshow, play from start. And here we have, so here's Alvo Portugal comes up. We welcome the class or the people that's at the presentation. We talk a bit. Now we start speaking about our presentation. We hit enter. And our text is going to fly in now. Okay, so we can hit the enter button, the text flies in. So instead of our enter button being used to bring in the different slides, now it's been used to bring in, as well as the different slides, it's been used to bring in the different key points or the different numbers that we have there. So we talk about Alvor a bit. People can see what's on the board. We click the enter key or the key on your mouse or your phone or whatever it is. And you say, now I'm going to speak about some of the key attractions that Alvor has. The first one we have is 3.5 kilometers of beach. So you can talk about this 3.5 kilometers of beach all you want until you're ready to go on to the next point. People don't know. So you have straight away, you have the audience's attention because they're waiting on what's coming next. You're not losing them. So we click on enter, you speak about the elevated walkway, you speak about the historic buildings and so on until you're ready, and then you go on to the next section and you do it there. So straight away you're starting to capture the audience, you're starting to get their attention that they are not reading on ahead of you. You can also do the same with pictures. Click on the picture, go to animations, and we can then go to whichever we want, maybe dissolve in or blinds, whatever we want to do, and we can take it in or fly in. We can leave it flying in. And if I go back again, then I'm just going to go back one slide and I'm going to start a slideshow from current slide this time instead of from the other one. So I go current slide and I'm going to go, there's the first one in, we talk about it, the second one's in, the third one's in and the fourth one's in. We go on to the next slide. And then what we do is we can show a picture whenever we want. So we can talk a bit and then hit the button and the picture pops in for us. So you can see there straight away, you're in control of the presentation now as opposed to the other way around. Now, one of the other things I like to do when using animation is taking things in and taking things out, both. So we have the things coming in now, and you can see them on the right hand side. It's green in, green, green, green. So they're all flying in. Now, what I want to do is we want to select the first one. I'm going to go to animations here at the top. But instead of flying in, I'm going to get it to fly out. So I'm just going to get it to fly out again, and we do it. Now, so you can see here, it's gone in as number 5. You can see it. So we have 3.5 kilometers coming in, and them all coming in, and then the first one going out. I'm going to bring that up so it is number 2. So that bit of text is flying in, then it's flying out. I'm going to do the same with the other ones, just very quickly. I'll talk my way through it. So the first one, we have it flying in. Number 3 is elevated walkway flying in. Then we're going to do elevated walkway flying out. Again, I'll put it up so that it's up at number 3. So I want to put it down 1. So you can see green's coming in, red's going out. Historic buildings then. Now you could do this all at the time. I just wanted to show you, first of all, if you're doing it for yourself, obviously you would do it as you're doing it. So historic buildings, I'm too far again, 5 and 6. And the last one we want is restaurants and bars. Okay, and it's going out. And it's okay to have that one at the very end. So you can see here, I can put it down so you can see it. So animation number one is 3.5 kilometers coming in. Number 2 is going out. Then 3 is elevated walkway going out, coming in, out, in, out. So I'm going to run it from this slide. So I hope you're still with me now. So what we're doing is we're going to bring in a bit of text. We're going to speak about it. We're going to hit it. It's going to go away. And then we're going to bring in the next bit of text. So the people that we're looking at are only focusing on the thing that we are talking about. So we go to our slideshow. And we play from current slide, because it's okay to do it from this one. So this is still all a testing period. So we bring in 3.5 kilometers of beach. Then we press return, it goes away. Press return again, the next one comes in, we speak about it. Then we press return, it goes away, comes in, goes out, comes in, goes out. And then we're on to the next slide. We could also, I know we're getting away, but I'm going to copy this picture, because it's going to be one that we could use. We could put in as well, we could put a picture here on our slide. I'm going to leave it there. And I'm going to click on it. And at the minute, we have no animation on it. It copied the animation from the last time. So what I want to achieve with this, now you can see what we're doing now is we're starting to build up our repertoire of things that we can do. So we've brought 3.5 in. We're taking 3.5 out. Now, what I want to do is, when 3.5 kilometers comes in, I want to bring in this picture. So I'm going to click on the picture. I'm going to add an animation for the picture to appear. So it's appear or fly in or whatever. We'll use fly in because the rest of them's all fly in. Now, it went in as number 9 because it's the last one. And we just need to make sure that it's up where we want it. So there. Okay, so you can see the layout of it here. So 3.5 kilometers of beach is coming in, and then we have a picture coming in, and then we better put the picture out. So we click on it, we exit, and we fly out, and then we're going to put this up here. So it's getting very complicated now, getting into it well. So we put it in and out. So 3.5 kilometers is coming in. The picture comes in, the picture goes out, the writing goes out, and then the new writing comes back in. And you can add to this over and over again to build up your presentation. So we go to slideshow, play from current slide. So we bring in the first bit of text. It's going to come in for us. Then we bring in the picture. We can speak about the picture all we want. People can see exactly what's on the picture. We put away the picture, put away the text, and we bring in the next one. Okay. And we can build it up like that. We can then put in another picture. I'm not going to do them all. I'm just going to do this one so you can see the way it works. Pictures. I'm going to do it from file. And I have the pictures here. Okay, so we're just going to put a boat in. No, that is the boat. This one. I'm going to put the picture in. I'm going to put it to the same size. Notice the way when we're not using the placeholders now to put the pictures in, it's a lot harder. We have to manipulate the pictures. Okay, so there's my picture in of the boat. And I'm going to add an animation going in. So I'm going to fly it in. And I'm going to add an animation flying out. Okay, they will be down at the bottom here. Picture 11. I want it to be after elevated walkways comes in. And picture 11 going out, I want it to be before elevated walkways goes out. So have I got that right? This needs to be down to there. Okay, so elevated walkways comes in, the picture comes in, the picture goes out, elevated walkways goes out. So you can see now we're up to 12 bits of animation here so far that we have. But this would make your presentation, people would say, wow, look at this. Okay, so we start our presentation. People say 3.5 kilometers comes in. Then our picture comes in. We talk about it. We put it out. We put away the text. We take in the new text. We take in the picture. We talk about it. Picture goes away. Text goes away. The new text goes in. And we haven't any more pictures there. But you can see exactly now what we're trying to build up. And you would need to then save this to make sure nothing happens it. And you would have to go in and out and make sure it works right and make sure everything's coming in and out the way they are. But you can see with the animations over here on the right hand side, you can control what's coming in. And you have all these pictures or all these wee numbers here to show you exactly what's going in and going out and when it's going in and out. So I hope you enjoyed that lecture. It is getting very, very advanced now. We're getting up there with it. So this is where we want to be at. We want to start getting into this, that we can make our presentations look better than the other person's presentations. You want to give a person the presentation and the person coming behind you says, oh no, I don't have to go after this. Okay, so we're on the right track. So we'll see you in the next lecture.